Hello, in this tutorial on C++, I want to continue the operator overloading with the next big class. Alright, we made today the plus equal and minus equal and such an operators. Okay, I have to rewrite the code, but it is basically the same. So, yeah, in this so we will add the thing reference back and make it an operator plus equal. Alright, inside that it is wait for a thing reference. Okay, we will define outside of the class. So thing colon colon and without a semicolon. Alright, we are here. Usually yeah, make it double, make it equal, oh not double, something, make it equal to add some name for this, for example t dot something. Okay, something and not equal plus equal. Alright, this will be just add to the something which is in this class, and the t dot something, it is just add to something, and yeah, that's it pretty much, and we return with this. Okay, here's the usefulness of this pointer. We will use the indirection operator, so make it actually a class and then return the reference of it, and that's it. So now we can write it here that make two class. So I forget to make constructors, never mind, I will make it quickly. So thing, and it makes a double. Okay, thing double D. Okay, and makes something equal to D. Alright, just to make a constructor, so yeah, thing T1 10 and think T2 5. Alright, make T1 plus equal T2 and write out the T1. Okay, that's it. We pretty much just add the 10 and the 5 in this case, so not really interesting, we could do it without it. But as I said earlier, there are more complex example when, for example, 100 lines is inside this addition, so there is it really useful. For now, just compile the program if it can compile. So first.cpp. Okay, dot get thing, because we didn't declare this ostream operator yet, but we will. Okay, we have a get thing, no. Great, so double get thing return something. Okay, now we can compile the program and now we can run the program. Okay, and as you can see, it's add the 10, so the 10 and the 5. Alright then, and that was pretty simple, right? You can define its overload operator like minus equal, times equal, so multiplied and equal sign and division and equal sign and so on. So these are really no, this is really no make. So these really makes no difference. Okay, the assignment operator is a little bit different in this way that you have to check that. So you don't want to something write something like this, because this would make catastrophic if you wouldn't check the self-assignment. So the simplest way to avoid the catastrophic you need to compare this not equal to address of t. Then we want to run everything inside here, and actually you don't want to this to be there, and yeah, okay, this will give back a reference. Usually a main rule is if you just change something you give back the reference, if you create something new you will give back the object itself. For example, in plus you will create an object, a new object, because both the left and both the right operand unchanged. So if t3 equals t1 plus t2, then both t1 and t2 will be unchanged, just the t3 change. Okay, and yeah, let's make that too. Alright, so this is very important, always check that isn't it self-assignment, although in this case it wouldn't be catastrophic because we just make something like 10 equals 10 and make 10 to 10, so it will not be catastrophic. But every case you have a dynamic memory allocation, by the way, you should declare this manually if you have a dynamic memory allocation, you will have a catastrophic, because if you first every time you will delete the allocated memory, and then you want to copy everything from this T. And if you already delete memory and you want to copy from T, which is actually the deleted memory, because someone writes something like this, T1 equals T1, so first you delete this, but with this you delete this. Clear? I don't think so, but never mind, we will make an example, a vector class which will demonstrate why is it useful, and why is this useful, and how to allocate memory, and just a very simple basic example. It gives you an example which helps you to understand. Alright. So t1 equal t2, and then we can compile it if we don't forget to save it, or get this plus sign from here, so we can compile it, and as you can see t1 becomes the t2, actually the value of t2. Alright.